Taiwan in this tutorial, I am going to talk about the fork and in Unix Milieu, which is a multi-user, multi-processing operating system. Each process has a unique process identification number, and the following command, psaux, is a machine depending, and it's what a machine is currently do in Unix milieu, in Unix environment. My computer is Windows, and I have two programs, one Pele C and the other Lab Windows, and the fork doesn't work. It tells that it is an external command and it doesn't work. But because it is very, very popular and very good function, I am going to talk about that, only talk about what is happening. When we use in Unix environment psaux, it appear in such a table, and when you use also control delete alt in your Windows 10, it appears also all those a table of all those things. The first line contains headings, the remaining lines supply information about each process and the user's login name, the process identification number, and so forth. The operating system runs many processes concurrently by time sharing the machine resources. In Unix, the programmer can use fork to create a new process called the child process that runs concurrently with the parent process. It is not part of ANSI C. The function fork takes no argument and returns an int only, and it is an example. We have a in studio, include studio, in main function, define an integer fork void, and another integer value, variable value, and initiate value with fork. It starts a new process, and you are going to print value, and the output of this program is the value. In the first step is 17,219, and in other step is zero. As noted, when fork is invoked, it creates a new process, the child process. The new process is an exact copy of the calling process, except that it has its own process identification number. The function called fork returns zero to the child, and it returns the child's process ID to the parent. In the output of our program, the first line was printed by the parent and the second line by the child. Also, the first value is parent's identification, and the second is the child. Let us modify this program by adding the code, a second copy of the statement value equal fork, and we are going get the same. The first stop is the value of parent, and the second is value of child. And when we call value again, the parent has slipped, and its value is zero, and the child has such a value. The children have unique process identification number, the program created for concurrent versions of main. The order of execution of this process is in system dependent and the non-deterministic. That is, the order is not necessarily the same for each execution of the program. Invoking fork too many times can cause the system to fail by exhausting all available processes. When fork is invoked, it creates two processes, each with its own set of variables. If a file pointer is used, however, care must be taken because the file pointer in each of the processes will refer to the same underlying file. The value returned by fork can be used in an if-else statement to discriminate between the actions of the child and the parent. In our next program, we are compute Fibonacci numbers in the child process and print elapsed time in the parent's process. We use sleep to suspend execution of the parent process for 2 second interval. I checked in time.h and I couldn't find the function sleep in lab windows, and I am going to check here. I am going to check in the Pelesi. In Pelesi, include time. Open with LSC, but it doesn't answer my sleep function, I suppose, and I cannot find in this in Pelesi either. Anyway, we define functions int Fibonacci int or int for void, or we can declare this line inside the main function and void the sleep unsigned. And in int main void, int we declare a variable, integer variable begin, and initialize it with time null and another variable I, and I am going to start the fork. If fork equal 0, it starts the child process, and for I make a for loop in 30 steps, and I am going to find the Fibonacci, and after that, if fork is not 0, the parent as are running this one, we are going to use the elapsed time and the time minus begin, which is here, and we are going to, and the Fibonacci is a function if n is less than or equal 1, return n. Otherwise, return we'll call again Fibonacci of n minus n plus Fibonacci n minus 2. When this program is executed, the output of two processes are intermixed in a non-deterministic fashion. And I am going to talk about another thing, which I cannot run it in PLSC because you need the prompt, and depending on how you compile your programming prompt. But we have already on all our in all of our programs, we have used int main void, but you can use an integer argc and a character pointed argv. And inside this program, you are going to declare a variable I of type integer, and you are going to use printf with a string argv of 0. The first character in argv, because it is a pointer of character, then it counts as array. And if argc, if we are going to start a loop we are beginning starting from 1, while I is less than argc, then printf argv of I, the list of those characters, we are going to also use it is very good that you have one or two arguments C, and you have two or three files that you want call them to read, print, do another thing with your files. And in this program, we are going to define or declare three integer variables I, sum equals 0 and value, and for I from 0 and until while I is less than argc, and we are going to use scanf. We are going to scan from the string, that string, and we are going to put scan the array and put it in the value. And if it is yes, it is correct. If it is you haven't reached the end, you are going to increment sum with value and put it in value. And at last, we are going to write the argv 0 and the number of command lines. When you compile the program, you are going to use in prompt cc-o. If your files is pgm1, it must have pgm1.c and also pgm2.c. Observe that those two are executable files in the current directory, and we are going to execute them. But when you want to use the files or another file, it's not necessary. You are going to use a cc-o, your program.c, and you are going to write your file names that it can find it in your directory. And another thing I wanted to talk about, it was the signals. Signals is an exceptional condition and is generated by abnormal event. For example, the user may type a control.c to affect an interrupt, or a program error may cause a bus error or a segmentation fault. A floating point exception occurs when two very large floating numbers are multiplied, or when division by zero is attempted. And CC provides the function signal in the standard library. Its functions, function prototype, and some macros are in signal.h, which is the header file. The material in this section applies to both MS-DOS and UNIX as symbolic constants in signal. Some few examples, it is sigint 2, it is interrupt, sigint, it is signal interrupt, sigil, this illegal instruction, sigfpe, floating point exception, sigsevv, segment violation. Although the signal that can be handled are system dependent, the ones that we have listed are common to most C system. If an exceptional condition occurs in a process, then the typical default action of the operating system is to terminate the process. The programmer can use signal function signal to invoke a signal handler that replaces the default system action. The function prototype is void a pointer function signal which has parameter int sig, int another void another pointer of function with parameter int, and all that signal has int as a parameter. This function called signal sig func associated to signal sig with the signal handle function. This causes the system to pass say as an argument to function and invoke it when the signal sig is raised. Some special signal handler are defined as macros in a header file. Signal we will use two of them, define sig dfl, which has such a description, and signal ignore. DFL is default, EGN is ignore, and it has such a expression. The cast caused the constant to have a type that matches the second argument in function signal. Here is an example that we are going to write. Ignore floating point exception. You are going use the signal floating point and ignore it. And another take default action to floating point signal. If a standard signal handler is inappropriate in a given application, the programmer can use function signal to catch a signal and handle it as desired, as you wish. Imagine wanting to use an interrupt to get the attention of a program without terminating it. This program shows how you can use it. And I cannot run this one because it doesn't work well. And I only go through, we are going to define a max string 100. We are going to declare two functions, control C handler int with a parameter sig as integer, and Fibonacci number function which we saw up there. In main function, we are going to declare a variable I of type integer, and we are going to use signal sig interrupt by control C handler. And we are going to start a loop, and we are going to write Fibonacci numbers, and if it happens something wrong, this is going to be invoked. Now we are going to define our function control C handler, and we are going to make a array of characters answer, and we are going to put a message if that one happened. We are going to get a message, and we are going to scan with the string, and we are going to put it in answer, because answer is an array is a pointer. We don't use a address sign, which is and. And if pointed answer is equal C, because it's after the interrupt, it's going to ask you if you want continue or quit. If you are entering C, means continue, and you are going to use the interrupt by this handle, and otherwise you are going to continue your process. Otherwise, you are going to exit the program. Allocation of matrix is the same as allocation of each variable, and there is nothing left here. Okay, it was all in this tutorial. See you on next tutorial, which I am going to go through lab windows with a graphical user interface for you, and it is all. Thank you. See you on next tutorial, which is graphical user interface.